Days. How have you been, mate?
Mate, I'm good. I'm so happy to be back on Australia's number one network, where it all began. Channel 7, love this place.
You guys have clearly got a bit of history together.
Yes. Dude, Jason and I did, not Happy to Lie, we did Dancing with the Stars.
Dancing with the Stars.
Seven season.
Yeah. What was the future?
I remember that picture being taken. Wow, looking good. Looking good.
Really good times. We're good mates. It's really nice to see you again.
Mate,
today,
mate.
Congratulations. Yeah. Take us back to that very first day. You set foot on the set of Home and Away. What was it like?
Oh, it was a dream come true, a dream role. I mean, it was an ensemble cast day. We had Alf, we had Sally, we had all the cast in a giant hall, and Robbie had this giant monologue about inventing a disco ball or something, and it was, you know, very daunting but very exciting at the same time.
Nailed it?
No, yeah, one take, one day.
You spent a lot of time on screen with Chris Hemsworth, it's awesome, you shot there, you guys, your two characters were friends, and then you guys caught up earlier this year, just about 10 years since leaving the Bay. How was the reunion?
Oh, look, so you can't go wrong with a Summer Bay reunion. He's an absolute legend, like, you know, he's one of the good guys, Chris, you know. We're still in touch all the time right now, yeah.
Any chance Robbie Hunter will come back?
Never say never, but the idea, I would say, you know, he hooks up with Mal, a bit of comedy, older than the other woman kind of thing.
Oh, there's the reunion there.
Yeah, that was good.
Who's that girl down the front?
That's Cambridge. Villanovian. Kate, we've got Victoria, Beck, producer, Chris, Liam, we're all there. Fun night, really fun night, that one.
Good days, Matt. Was a great start, you know, for a young actor getting into such a hit show.
Absolutely. The best training ground. Like, you learn every single day. It was one of my best memories I've got from myself on that show.
Like I said in the intro, you've extended your the feathers in your cap. You're now on the radio. What's your radio background?
Triple threat, mate. Triple threat. What's next? What's next? Well, how's the radio thing? It's good fun. I mean, I started in radio when I was 13, community radio up in Hornsby. So it's always something I wanted to do. The acting thing took off, and the right role came up at the right time with Nova. Ticked all the boxes, and now I've got my own show nationally across Australia.
Congratulations.
That's great. Thank you very much.
Kerry Ritchie is in the Nova family, so she's up to your old pal from Home Away.
Yeah.
Giving you any tips?
Yeah, but she has given me a lot. Just keep it real, have fun. Nova is only open to people who are Summer Bay residents now, so we just encourage them to come and join the team.
The boys coming soon.
Yeah, probably.
We also mentioned, Captain, that you're doing some writing. Talk to us about that. What are you doing?
Well, I'd actually worked for Home and Away for quite some time, so I went back and did that, and more recently I worked on Power Rangers. So I worked in development and did a whole bunch of scripts working on that for about a year and a half, actually. So that was like a thing, I think. I grew up watching Power Rangers as a kid, and I became one of the delights of the show, so another dream role for me.
What do you prefer?
Like,
there are all these
different
things that you can do.
Yeah. Good question. I like acting, I like presenting. I think the two TV and radio, this is a great synergy, so hopefully I can keep expanding on that and see what happens next.
I'm a radio head. I mean, I really enjoy listening to it, to talk back to everything, to the music. What's the art to being a great presenter and connecting with an audience?
Well, it's all about, I go for music passion and a vibe personally for me, but I think if you're talking, you've got to connect to the audience. So locality, connecting with what people are doing during the day, what they want to hear. Yeah, I'm just about the vibe, really.
And I suppose also hearing from them too, right? 13, 24, 10.
Give me a call anytime. I'll take your requests, surprises, anything you want. I've got it.
I can't let you go, Jason, without talking to you about Tommy.
I can't
let you go. On Dancing with the Stars.
Yeah.
I signed the agreement years ago.
I can't mention anything that happened, but shenanigans is the key word.
It's
good times. I mean, it was Dancing with the Stars was like huge. Still is. But yeah, good time. We had a great time.
I think for all of us, it was the second season.
Yeah.
So, you know, there weren't so many rules. And Jason and I tried to start implementing rules, and the rules
were
quite, well, celebrating after a show.
Yeah, that was the key. Yeah, I mean, alcohol ban, of course, and celebrations, no drinking.
And then poor Jason would obviously have to jump on the plane and go home to the set of 100 Away the very next day.
Yeah, I certainly look at this beautiful dancing there. That is probably one of my better dances. That would be the jive.
Looks like a bit of a jive there. You're doing a bit of walking.
That's beautiful stuff. But yeah, we had a great time and we made it fun. That was the key to it. Just made it At ease, mate. Thank you.
You can be Jason's weeknight on Vodafone.
Still to come, we have your full weekend.